Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I get so many questions about what kind of noodles can I eat? And the answer is often none, but I forgot all about kelp noodles. You can have kelp noodles and they look a little translucent, but they're almost no calories and they do not have a negative effect on your hormones. So if you want to see how I soften kelp noodles to make them taste just like their regular pasta, then stay tuned. So this is the kelp noodle brand that I purchased most recently. It's by Sea Triangle. It's a noodle company. And the only two places I've ever seen these noodles is Whole Foods or Amazon. So if you want to purchase them, I will put a link below, or you can go search in the Asian section of Whole Foods, and normally these noodles are on the bottom shelf. So these noodles don't have to be cooked, but when you take them out of the package, they are quite rubbery. And if you eat them like that, they're gonna be pretty nasty. I've actually done it before, and I think that's probably the reason why I shied away from them and didn't try to put them in recipes, but you can soften them. And when you soften them, they taste just like regular pasta. So there is a quick and easy process to get these noodles soft. First, you're going to start off with the juice of a lemon and then some baking soda, just regular plain old baking soda, not baking powder, baking soda. Now we're going to open the container, turn on the water, and let the noodles rinse. And all you're gonna do is just break them apart and wash them. Just kind of wash them in plain water. Just let the water run through them. And primarily, normally I would be using a strainer, but my kitchen is still not put all the way back together and I cannot find my colander yet. So we'll get there eventually. But you're just gonna take the water, let the water run over the noodles and rinse. So you'll rinse until about 30 to 45 seconds are up. And you'll get a feel, because the texture will change a little bit. And ideally, you'll take the colander and strain off all the water. You do your best to get rid of all the water. It's not important that all the water be gone. So next, you're gonna cut the lemon in half. And you don't want the seeds. So you either use a lemon juicer, and when I use this lemon juicer, I usually cut the ends off because more of the juice comes out, but you are going to either squeeze it and get rid of the seeds, or you'll use a lemon juicer. And in this case, I'm gonna use the lemon juicer to put the lemon juice in this bowl that we're gonna use to soften the kelp noodles. So squeeze that in there. So you're going to use the juice of one full lemon. Well, next you're going to add your baking soda. That's a full teaspoon of baking soda. So you're going to add it to the lemon juice. And you see how it's fizzing? That's exactly what you want to happen. And you're going to take your fork and stir it around in the lemon. And it's going to bubble. So make sure you're using a big enough bowl so that the bubbles don't overflow and cause you to have a little explosion all over your countertop. But eventually what's gonna happen is those bubbles are gonna stop and settle down. So you just keep stirring it until you get to a point where you're not really hearing it sizzle so much. It might take a minute or so, but you just let it sit and then get your noodles ready to add to the bowl. Now all you do is add the noodles to the bowl. And then you coat the noodles with the lemon baking soda combination, and as you move it around the bowl, the noodles will start to soften up. This will take about a minute or so, but during this process, you can also just let the noodles sit in the bowl. You don't have to continue to move the noodles around, especially once the noodles are already coated with the lemon and the baking soda. So would you see how the texture has changed? And you just let them sit for a minute, and then The next step is to rinse that lemon and baking soda off of the noodles. But the thing that I love about these noodles is that they take on the flavor of whatever you flavor them with. So the herbs and spices that you put on the noodles, that's what they're gonna taste like. They don't have a weird taste like kelp, if you will. So now what you wanna do is rinse that baking soda and lemon off of the noodles, because if you don't, it's gonna taste like lemon and baking soda. And you don't wanna do that. I've heard of people doing that, and I don't think it's very good. So you rinse it and drain it. And of course, like I said before, it's better to use a colander. But you definitely wanna make sure you wash this thoroughly. I found my little juicer strainer. It came with my juicer, so I'm gonna use this instead. It's very difficult to mess with these noodles after they have been softened. They'll fall out of the bowl since the texture has changed so much from the lemon and baking soda mixture. So I'm just gonna give them a little rinse just to make sure all of that baking soda and lemon is off of the noodles. Once the noodles are drained, you transfer them to a bowl. And the thing about these is that you do not need to cook them. If you start cooking them once they are translucent like this and softened, they will taste very bad because they will get really, really slimy. So it's best if you are gonna cook with these to just add them to your meal after your main dish is cooked. So if you're gonna use it for spaghetti, you cook your sauce first and vegetables, whatever it is you're gonna put on top of your spaghetti, and you can warm these noodles up with hot water. You just run some hot water over them, drain them, and then pour your sauce over them. So that's it, y'all. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend. Don't forget to subscribe and tell me what you're going to make with these noodles. So of course, those of you who have been asking me for noodles, I am interested to hear what you make. Thanks so much for watching. Take care.